Hello there, this is No Nickname. Welcome back to another StarCraft 2 video. We are back in the lab, and we are ready to play the final Protoss mission. Zeratul has had some kind of vision, and we are now going to see what this vision is, and learn how we may be able to stop it.
Now, friend Raynor, you must see the Overmind's vision of the future. My people, and of all things, this is our fate, should Kerrigan die.
In utter darkness is the final Protoss mission. Our objective is to simply witness the apocalypse and go it with a bang, basically. Some more Zerg and Protoss research opportunities, which is always nice, and there's nothing more to say, really, so let's go.
I don't think I want to see any vision of the Overmind. But if Kerrigan's involved, I need to know.
On a distant, shadowed world, the Protoss will make their final stand. Their heroes will gather. Their forces will be marshaled, and they will die bravely. But still, they will die. And my Zerg will be slaves to the hybrid. All will bow before the power of the Fallen One.
Protoss brethren, heed me. The last twilight has fallen. The galaxy burns around us. The Terrans have been consumed. We are all that stands against the shadow. But if we are to meet our end this day, then we will do so as one, Antaro Tassadar!
Alright, I'm going to make plenty of probes here. Also going to make a robotics bay so that I can produce Colossus as soon as I can, as well as another forge. And I'm also going to make a third robotics facility.
Great one, the vault is prepared. Guard us while we preserve our knowledge for those that may follow. They must not make the mistakes we did.
So the secondary objective is to defend this for 25 minutes. If we do that, we'll get some research points. Right, I'm gonna start getting these upgrades as well. And I'm also going to get air upgrades. Group these in their old control group.
I have rallied the last of our great fleet.
Your timing is impeccable, Admiral Urun. When the enemy takes to the air, we will need your support.
Right. So we got a bunch of Phoenixes and a Phoenix hero guy. This will be useful later when we face hybrids and the like.
The Zerg performed their function as I planned. My hybrid are proof of this. Now, the last of the Protoss will fulfill their function in death.
Bring it on.
My burdens weigh heavily.
So here come the first enemies, gathering outside our base now and coming towards us. We have to kill 2,500 of them to succeed this mission. and then we have to die. But not before killing 2,500 enemies. So I'm gonna spam mostly Colossus in this. I'm also gonna make some Void Rays later when we unlock those, but other than that, it's mostly Colossus it's gonna be about.
The Zerg are swarming at our flanks. We have to react quickly or our perimeter defenses will fall.
Here come more Zerg. Got to group these up so that we can access them easily. The Phoenixes, I mean.
Upgrade complete.
Okay, let's get air weapons level 2. Gonna get air attack upgrades before armor or like hit points or whatever it gives. Alright, let's also group up all my Colossus in their own group.
You have not enough minerals.
You can see the Zerg messing up there now, so let's get over here next to defend. And I think I can stop making probes soon. Haven't really been making them all that much anyway, but... okay, let's Void Prism that so it doesn't cause any problems. Gonna make a few more Phoenixes for anti-air defense. Don't want to get overwhelmed by Mutalisks either, or Broodlords later. Okay, that's the final amount of work I'm gonna make, I think. There's an expansion here, but we don't need to get that. The minerals in our base are gonna be just fine. And we're low on gas, but we still have minerals, so I'm gonna make a few cannons. Just as a mineral sink, basically.
All shall be remade in my name. Behold, my greatest creation.
Here come the hybrids.
Base is under attack.
These are rather powerful, but they can be lifted up by our Phoenixes. And that makes them pretty much useless. So they killed a bunch of cannons, but that's fine.
I'm detecting a large amount of Zerg activity in their hive clusters. Prepare for an assault.
Alright, more Zerg. We're just streaming in one at a time almost now. Quite easy to kill. Alright, now we can get more upgrades. And here's a bunch of Mutalisks, so let's kill those. And here's come attackers on the other side as well, so we have to multitask a bit. But we have it under control now.
Base is under attack.
Apparently my Colossus that I had units coming to died. Oh. Don't want to lose this archive either. I want that research. There's some Broodlords, so let's go and kill those. Let's warp in just a few stalkers to kill these mutalisks as well.
Your warriors have engaged the enemy. You require more Vespin gas.
Our void rays are ready to do their part. Disengage prism inhibitors and concentrate all batteries on the hunt.
Well met, great Mohandar. Or ire.
Now we have void rays. I'm gonna make a few of those. Not too many, I'm gonna focus on Colossus, but some void rays can't hurt. So I'm gonna group those with my Phoenixes as they're both flying units. Let's make a few more cannons here as well, seeing as we have so much minerals anyway. I'll make them behind you for the most part, just to defend this archive if it falls under attack.
You require more Vespin gas.
Guess we can warp in a few salads too. And let's replace that pylon that died and put us under 200 supply. I think I'm gonna move this just so it doesn't get detected immediately.
Base is under attack.
Picking up the hybrids. Let's see. Random Colossus standing here. Let's bring that over as well as the Void Rays. They can be queued up to get with the other Void Rays. We have a lot of Colossus now. We're almost at 200 out of 200 supply.
You require more Vespin gas. You require more. This base is under attack.
So they're coming from both sides here again. That is just fine though. Ouch. I'm gonna try to not die. And we did so successfully. Lost a bunch of Colossus there, but that's fine.
You require more Vespin gas.
We've killed almost 1,000 enemies now.
The final hour. We stand as one.
I'm not going to bother with more warp gates or anything, I don't really need them.
You require more Vespin gas.
Luckily Colossus can walk over these cannons, so it doesn't matter if we block something in or something. And of course the Void Rays can fly, so that's also good.
Every hand is turned against you. Even the ground beneath your feet carries the seeds of your destruction.
Well, at least he warned us about Nidus Worms. In a somewhat weird way, but they're under our feet.
This is the hour of truth, noble Templar. Let the enemy know the wrath of Ire's champions.
Executor Salendus, unleash the full power of your forces. There may be no tomorrow.
Alright, now we have carriers too.
Intaro Tassadar, Zeratul.
Those are gonna help quite a bit. not going to train any more often, I think. They're kind of expensive, so I'm going to focus on other units. And they're probably going to survive for the remaining mission almost too, so... as they're quite powerful and don't really die that easily unless you sacrifice them. As they tend to stay back in the army anyway.
We tarry too long.
I am the heart. You address me?
Almost killed 1,000 units now.
You require more Vespine gas.
Oh, I shouldn't have done that. Now I can't make another Colossus. Well, units will die soon, shortly anyway.
We stand as one. Our suffering must end. Your warrior base is under attack.
Observer died. Rest in pieces. Gathering outside there as well. Let's get our Colossus over here. So my army is kind of massive, which is pretty cool. Continuing to spam cannons as well. Only need to protect that for 5 more minutes. Then we can technically retreat up to our base here. That'll just basically give us less ground to cover. But I'll stay down here as long as I can, I guess. As I have a bunch of cannons here. No, I haven't gotten this. Should do that. Let's get that too. Focus on attack before life.
As I was your beginning, so shall I be your end.
Well, good luck with that, dark voice. It isn't working out very well for you now, at least. They are now dead. More mutalisks over there. This. Should take out those, definitely.
We are at full power.
Your warriors have engaged the enemy.
Alright, so let's get our Colossus a bit back, just so... Or at least collect them a bit more. We're actually pretty collected anyway. We're actually almost reaching our goal already. Which I guess if we're alive right now, then... you will almost have this many kills. Let's make some more Void Rays. Guess make another Phoenix as well to pick up more guys. Running kinda low on Phoenixes. Couple of Scyllas because why not?
You must construct additional pylons.
Oh, I must construct additional pylons. Okay, I guess we can get shields as well. Why not, right? And this upgrade too.
You have no place to hide and nowhere to run.
Nidus worms. Let's take out those. Unfortunately, those swarmlings don't actually count towards the kill count. Otherwise, we would be getting a bunch of kills in it right now. Alright, just kill them already. Finally!
You require my skills.
Base is under attack.
Oh, that's just a lot of stuff. We have reached our secondary objective now, by the way. Didn't quite notice that. Alright, Colossus own everything, apparently. Let's get the next shield upgrades, because why not?
Upgrade complete.
We tarry too.
I will be redeemed. My allegiance is yours.
Oh, come on, attack me already. There we go. Oh. Okay, get over there.
Base is under attack. Base is under attack.
We tarry too.
As I said, I don't really have to be down there now anyway, so I'm just gonna stay up here for the most part.
This is Hierarch Artanis, commanding the Shield of Iron. Our matrix fields are within range. Engaging mass recall!
Alright, we got the mothership now.
My brethren, hear me. But there is little time left. All that remains of our race, our civilization, are those that stand beside you now. Trust. Strike as one will. Let our last stand burn a memory so bright, we will be remembered forever. Entaro Tassadar!
Tearing tumult.
Shall prevail.
Foolish, prideful children. There was one among you who could have jeopardized my great plan. But in your recklessness, you mistook her for the true threat.
The Queen of Blades. How could we have known?
Upgrade base is under attack.
So now our only objective is to die.
If only we had acted sooner.
There goes Ceratul. So there's really no point dragging this out, but I'm gonna try to survive a bit longer just because why the hell not? Might as well die with pride, I guess. This mothership also cloaks all units, or it's really a mothership, it's actually a guy, it's Artanis, but cloaks all of our units, so that actually helps out quite a bit. Sacrificing all my probes. You too, come on.
Your warriors have engaged the enemy. I am eager to strike. Base is under attack. Our path is clear. Our thoughts are one. March forward.
I guess I'll just let them destroy my buildings. I'll just stay out here and die over the archives. May someone else come here and discover the remains of our civilization one day.
March boldly without fear.
Vortex. I should use that. Also the Mash Recall. I think I'm gonna wait for a good opportunity to use this vortex. Like, I can actually lose 5 vortexes, that would be actually kind of awesome.
Your efforts are futile. My harbingers will usher in a new age.
Your warriors have engaged the enemy.
Right, hybrids.
Your warriors have engaged the enemy. Dawn will come. Rock, ready by us. Faith before fear. Strength in unity.
Still surviving. Oh, these can't actually even see me, so they're just gonna get killed. Oh, actually, I don't think they even can attack air units. Which is everything I have left now.
Our thoughts are one. March boldly without fear. Our path is. We shall strength in unity. There can be no doubt.
Is this really the best you have, hybrids? That's more like it. Alright, the protos are falling.
There's
just too many of them.
Forgive me, great Tassadar. I wasn't strong enough.
So he used the Zerg to kill the Protoss, then he himself killed off the rest of the Zerg. And the universe is now in utter darkness. Well, it will be if the prophecy comes true anyway. To prevent this, we have to save Kerrigan, and there's a lot of people right now who really want to kill her. We succeeded with all the research and stuff. Killed a lot of units, so let us continue and hope this doesn't actually happen.
Friend Raynor, you now bear witness to the truth. There is a malevolent presence within the void that seeks to destroy everything we hold dear. Could this fallen one be Azel Naga? After so long, could the gods themselves seek our destruction? And Kerrigan, I can hardly believe the wretched Queen of Blades will prevent the destruction of all that we know. Raynor, you may soon hold Kerrigan's fate in your hands. I know only that she must live. Be wary, old friend. The Hounds of the Void are on the hunt.
So that was all of the Protoss missions. I'm really looking forward to Legacy of the Void, which is the Protoss part of the campaign. That's not coming out for a few years, and I also, of course, have Heart of the Swarm to play. I haven't done that yet either. But before that again, I have to go finish this campaign, so there's a lot to do. So, hi there, Tosh.
Damn, brother. You look like you could use a drink.
I saw the last vision Zeratul put into the crystal. It was a look into the future. A final battle against the hybrid. Armageddon. Somehow, Kerrigan's the key to preventing it.
Who knows how the wheel turns? Cycles upon cycles. This much I know. Those that see the future best take heed. It's both a gift and a curse.
But is it cast in stone? That's what I need to know.
Who knows? I've heard you say we are who we choose to be. If that be true, the future cannot be fixed.
Hankering for some down-home cooking out there in the space lanes? Come on down to Bubba's Gas and Grub. We got two for Tuesdays, featuring barbecue mutawig. Also, free plasma charge with each fill up. Bubba's Gas and Grub, your space trucker home away from home.
Mutalisk wings? That sounds disgusting.
You look shaken, sir. What's wrong?
Zeratul called it a vision of the future. was the end times, Matt. Armageddon. More Protoss than we ever knew existed. But there still weren't enough to stop the hybrid.
Well, what about Kerrigan? Wasn't she supposed to stop them?
In this timeline, she was dead. Killed by us. That's what Zeratul's been trying to tell us all along. She has to live, or we're all doomed.
Oh, what the hell, cowboy? You look like crap. You been thinking about that girl again?
Kinda. I just got some bad news about what might happen if we can't save her.
No use worrying about what might happen, if you ask me. You want me to help, you just let me know.
Sir, you should check out the research console. There's some exciting developments there.
Yes, I believe there are. I think we actually are at the limit for Zerg research now. Let's check out the Zerg tank first. The sample is trying to escape. I've detected several new acids in the nutrient solution. Over time, they will crack the tank. I wonder if Commander Rainer can post some marines down here. No, they want to destroy it. I haven't learned everything I can from this thing yet. Breakthrough. I dosed some tissue with concentrated sigma radiation and it slowed growth and movement severely. It would take a lot of work to safely deploy that much radiation on the battlefield, but it might be worth it. Another breakthrough. This one scares me. I mapped my way through the DNA of some brain tissue, peering back thousands of years, and I isolated the strain from which the Zerg Overmind was derived. Not enough to clone the Overmind, but I could follow this strand to gain insight into how it controlled the Zerg. Very interesting. So let's see what kind of technology we can learn from this. Oh, message from the Mobius Foundation. Mr. Rainar, you have obviously learned the limit of what you can from Zerg biosamples. We would be happy to purchase any future samples you find for 10,000 credits per sample. Check this console if you find any further biosamples, and the funds will be instantly wired to your accounts. Dr. Narud. So we sold 2 samples and got 20,000 credits. So, as we cannot actually get any more points here, we can still gather the Zerg samples for money, which is kind of nice. So, the Hive Mind Emulator. It's a defensive structure that can permanently mind control Zerg units. You can see it converting the Ultralisk there, and you can then use it to kill all these Zerglings. The result of this, the Psi Disruptor, a defensive structure that slows movement and attack speeds of nearby Zerg. I think this sounds really useful. Especially if you have to defend an area or something like that, as you can see here. I mean, those Zerglings can barely move. So I'm going to go ahead and get that. I don't really see much use for the Hive Mind Emulator. So the Psi Disruptor it is. We only need one more Protoss point as well to get one of those, and we'll get that soon enough.
I don't suppose you could give me a sample of your brain tissue for study purposes?
No, I cannot. Alright, that's pretty much it. Well, there are mercenaries.
Lots of folks ready to fight. For the right price.
There is the Spartan Company, which are mercenary Goliaths. I'm not actually going to get those yet, though. If at all. I don't really find Goliaths that useful. So let us return to the bridge, which is where we'll be playing the remaining missions. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.